to students from John McRae Secondary School. Where are you? Make some noise. If I can have your attention, please, and give a big round of applause to the Canadian Wheelchair Basketball League CEO, Wendy Gittins.
Marks an important commitment that Wheelchair Basketball Canada has made to the ongoing development of the sport, and in particular to providing increased opportunities for female athletes. I would like to acknowledge the support of our incredible partners, the Government of Canada, Ottawa Tourism, Hollister Incorporated, Armored Suits, and Toyota Canada, for their commitment to Wheelchair Basketball Canada providing a safe and welcoming environment for all participants to achieve their performance goals. I also want to acknowledge all the guests and partners joining us today who are supporting this event. Also, big shout out to the volunteers whose tireless efforts behind the scenes ensured the smooth running of the event. Also, a round of applause for the volunteers. Thank you. As many of you already know, Wheelchair Basketball Canada will be hosting the 2026 World Wheelchair Basketball Championships right here in Ottawa in September of 2026. This 11-day event is the world's largest team sport event for high-performance athletes with a disability and will feature 28 teams and over 300 athletes. The tournament will be a celebration of sport inclusivity that unites people not only here in Ottawa, but across Canada and the world. I hope all of you join us as we bring the world to Ottawa in 2026. Finally, best of luck to the teams competing this weekend. We look forward to watching you showcase your skills and sportsmanship on the court. Thank you.
Thank you, Wendy. And now let's meet the rosters for today's game. La formation du match d'aujourd'hui, beginning with the lineup for Team Ontario. Number 3, Melanie Hockley. Number 4, Charlotte McElroy. Number 5, Taylor O'Shaughnessy. Number 6, Rosie Long. Number 7, Keisha Penoff. Number 8, Emily Moldau. Number 9, Danielle Duplessis. Number 10, Marissa McClellan. Number 11, Zoe Hahn. Number 13, Tamara Steves. Number 14, Celine Gibb. And number 15, Rebecca Knowles. Team manager, Tammy Lyle Gravlev. Assistant coach, Sarah Wortley. And head coach, Dylan Carter. How about a round of applause from Team Ontario? Their opponents. Team BC, number 1, Katie Badgema. Number 2, Tara Giannis. Number 3, Heidi Bowman. Number 4, Megan Smith. Number 5, Lily Brooke. Number 6, Kim Boland. Number 7, Marika McConkie. Number 8, Julia Townsend. Number 10, Lynette Boland. And number 13, Elise Freeze. Team manager, Nadine Barbasan. Head coach, Masa Hosseini. And assistant coach, Marty Abbott. Today's officials, Joanna Meekers from Alberta, Melissa Meacham from Saskatchewan, and Debbie Enstrom from Alberta. For those who are able to, please rise, remove your hats for the playing of the national anthem. Joignez-nous pour l'interprétation de l'hymne national. Thank you.
Please join us in welcoming the Honorable Carla Paltrow, Member of Parliament and Minister of Sport and Physical Activity. Minister Paltrow, thank you for joining us here today. Your support and education to inclusive and high-performance sport is truly inspiring. We are honored to have you with us today.
Thank you. Wheelchair basketball. Of course, as a Minister of Sport for Canada, I'm supposed to be neutral, so go Canada. But of course, my whole province is BC. Right? So I will be cheering only for everybody, I promise. So anyway, bienvenue to the moment. I'd like to acknowledge that we are gathered on the NC, the traditional territory of the Algonquin and Anishinaabe peoples. Welcome on behalf of the Government of Canada, the Prime Minister. You are in for such a treat, Ottawa. This will be excellent athletes playing excellent sport. Right, ladies? Right? So exciting to see women doing sport the best the way women can, with grit, with determination, with passion, with fun, and through friendship. So thank you all for being here. Every province is represented, which is fantastic. Congratulations, Wheelchair Basketball Canada, for all your work to provide opportunities for everyone to participate in developmental and high performance and an excellent sport. Wishing you all the best. I'm so excited. Thank you to the board of directors of Wheelchair Basketball Canada, to your team, to all the volunteers, to the coaches, to the officials, everybody. You are the reason why we get to do this kind of thing on some random Friday in March. So thank you all very much. I have the best job ever, and I know you guys probably get the best job ever. Welcome to Ottawa, enjoy the games, play hard, have fun, and I just wish you guys back to you that you are now. So thank you, take care.
Thank you, Minister Paltrow. Your inspiring words and your commitment to addressing equality and championing diversity. We are thrilled to collaborate with the Government of Canada as we prepare to welcome the girls of Ottawa by hosting the CWBL Wheelchair Basketball World Championships in September 2026. Together, we look forward to promoting and advancing equitable, inclusive, high-performance sport in Canada. Merci, Madame la Ministre Paltrow. Vos patrons et soutenants, votre engagement à aborder la question de l'égalité et à défendre la diversité. Nous sommes très bien heureux de vous avec le gouvernement du Canada, alors que nous préparons à accueillir le monde à Ottawa lors du championnat du monde de basketball en sport populaire de CWBL en septembre 2006. Ensemble, nous attendons avec hâte de promouvoir et de faire progresser le sport équitable, inclusif et de haute performance au Canada.
All right, we are set to go for the ceremonial tip-off. Minister Paltrow and team captains Tara Yannis and Tamara Steves. Thank you so much. Thank you.
proud of me?
Make sure you get my good side.
Yeah, I will.
Good day, everyone. Welcome to the 2024 Canadian Wheelchair Basketball League Women's National Championships. This afternoon will feature Team Ontario facing off against Team BC. We're streaming live from Collège La Cité in Ottawa. And I'll be your commentator today. My name is Bernard Casey, and with me is
Fabian Blizzard. I'm the newbie in this.
All right, today, Team BC, Team Ontario. This is Team BC's second game today. All right, we're starting off strong now with Team BC. Ball.
So number three, Borland has the ball. We got a shot from number 10. I find it so interesting is that those two swings and then just that little bit when you pivot, I thought that was an interesting rule.
It's a very technical sport. Combining chair control with ball control, as well as navigating through the court.
Great passing game.
And that Tara Smith takes a shot, and a good 2 points for Tara Smith. Correction, that was Megan Smith. Number four, Megan.
Great hook pass. Wow. Love the vision on that.
We're starting off strong on both sides of the court. Lots of energy.
Love the speed of the game too. Great pass to number 10.
Good offensive play for TPC.
Love the defense under the rim.
Nice shot by Tamara.
Great positioning for the box out.
Team BC still playing a hard defense. Very strong.
Great interception by number 10. Interesting when there's a fall too, but my rules that I heard, like as soon as a fall, the play has to stop to keep it safe.
That's correct. So we got Team BC making the inbound.
Number Trim Bolin.
Oh,
Looks like we have maybe sisters on the team, or
yes,
even related.
Three sisters. Yep. Oh, Heidi Bowling.
Yeah, number three.
Yeah. And Kim Bowling.
Number
so
six.
Number three,
yes.
Six. Vote from Pender Island, British Columbia. Strong representation today from Pender Island. I believe half the team's from Pender Island.
That's great pass.
Great pass to Emily Mordor.
Great look inside. She had great position on a seal.
Kid number six, Kimbolin bringing it up,
yeah.
Passing out. Tara gets her shot.
Movement. Great rebound transitioning right away. Oh, great defense.
Good recovery out there from Alyssa McMillan.
DBC foul on number three. Heidi Bolin picks up her first and the team's first foul. A pair of free throws for Larissa McMillan.
Right away we see transition. Love the way they try to slow it down too on defense, keeping them in behind. Great rebound. Love the screen action.
Good hustle.
Oh, nice.
By number two, Terry Ennis.
Good defense. Good deflections. Love the length that number nine Duplessis is giving on the floor. She's getting a ton of deflections. Great screen action. You see that out of bounds play for every team. We have that one. Get the shooter open in the corner. Again, good look inside. Their inside game is really interesting in the way they can find players.
And the game's first substitution, checking in for Team Ontario, number 14, Celine Gibb.
Terry is playing tight on defense. Great setup.
Very good pass.
Lynette Bolin. And with 5:03 remaining in the opening quarter, timeout call by Team Ontario. Le gouvernement du Canada est fier de soutenir les athlètes canadiens de basketball en haut de hula. Du terrain jeu au podium dans la poursuite de l'excellence sportive. The government of Canada is proud to support Canada's wheelchair basketball athletes from playground to podium in their pursuit of
of Sporting Excellence.
Number three is looking for that open player. They're going right into Danielle. Pushing the ball ahead, try to find an advantage. Great pass to number two. Great movement. Just a little too much power on that one, but that was a great look. Again, Team Ontario setting up. Team BC is picking up right away. We got a long range shot coming. Great rebound by Danielle. Again, pushing the ball. Oh, number 10.
Great pass up the court. Great defense by Ontario.
Definitely good recovery by Team Ontario. Team Ontario with the ball now. Team BC is doing such a great job trying to keep them outside the paint, but they keep finding Danielle. She's gonna find the end of that net. Again, good recovery, good screen action by BC.
Good shot.
From Kim Bolin.
Good shot by number six, Kim Bolin. Another two for BC.
Team Ontario looking to set up screen action with the roll to the rim. Beautiful. Good look inside.
Good shot by Larissa McClellan, number 10.
I love how aggressive they're being.
Very good first quarter. Yes.
I like how they're trying to keep Danielle out of the key, so they're slowing her down so they can get the height out.
Team Ontario going strong on defense. You know, they got to keep them out of the key.
Team BC is I like their gameplay.
They are very persistent. You know, just trying to find those holes in Ontario's defense.
Trying to find that opening, Yes. Too many seconds in the key there.
Team Ontario has one player out. Got a 4-4.
Again, Daniela with what? Danielle with one more rebound.
There we go.
Great job.
Good job. She's set up for that one. Number nine, Danielle Duplessis.
Love their court vision. The physicality and as aggressive as they are, it's just one. It's great to see.
Yes,
great sportsmanship. They're playing. Oh, sides. Beautiful.
And checking in for Team Ontario, number 5, Taylor O'Shaughnessy.
Great hook pass. Same play coming out of the out of bounds with the shooter.
There we go. Good shot.
Rainbow shot by number two,
Tara Yemis.
I think they're going to draw that one out.
I believe so.
Got in a minute, he's going to draw this out. I said, we don't want that play again. Great pass. Good rebound. Pushing again.
There we go. We got Megan Smith squeaking through there. Faster defense.
Yeah, 3-on-2. Beautiful.
Nice. Good play. Good play. You got a stop play, but smiles throughout. It's good. Everybody's having fun. Yes. Great sportsmanship on both sides.
That was a beautiful 3-on-2 play.
It was.
Coming down the middle. I love it.
Number 13.
Substitution on TPC. Elise Froze coming in. Number 13. So Elise played for the Team BC for the Canada Games out in Prince Edward Island.
Same play. Looking for it again. Great screen action from BC as well to give her that shot. Lots of movement. Love the way they're sharing the ball.
Great clean passes. Yes.
TPC foul on number 6 in Boland. Gives up the first. It's the team's third foul.
Oh, let's take a look at their out of bounds play. Simple
draw. Really simple, strong shot.
Yes.
Nice. Number 13, Tamara Steves got it right in. Yeah. Nice shot, Megan Smith. Running against the clock.
Really good.
Good quarter on both sides.
Yes. Very entertaining.
Yes. Yeah. Tight game.
I like the way both teams are using screen actions to really get their shooters open. I find this, from my first experience, this is great. This is good to be able to see and kind of the synergies between.
Great energy on both sides. Very surprised Team BC. They just finished the game about prior to this one.
Oh, wow.
Still going on strong. Nice to see. Great technical plays on both sides.
Yes.
Thank you, Messi, at Sarah's Kitchen, Aquella Apparel, and Jen Grant.
Thank you. Interesting team strategies on both sides of the court.
Oh,
let's
yes.
see what the second quarter brings.
Yes. I think for Team Ontario is some of the screen action that BC is putting on them to free up the outside or trying to get open or pull Danielle out so they can have openings to the rim. And then I know Team Ontario, they got to cover Danielle under the rim because they are just that screen and roll action with her right now is where they're getting the advantages. She's sealing really well inside.
We'll have number 8, Emily Modor, putting it bounded the play inbound for Team Ontario.
The Mercedes, did get, that was a good look though. That was a very good look to her.
Number 6, Kim Bolin, looking for that outlet. There you go, up to Elise, number 15.
Good screen action by number 2 on that one.
There you go, Ontario bringing it strong. Changing up their offensive strategy a bit.
Oh, nice. Nice hook pass. 5 seconds on the shot clock.
Fisher's on, nice long shot.
Great recovery long.
Yeah. ABC foul on number 4, Megan Smith. That's her first and the team's first foul.
Bound to happen because they have a lot of screen actions in their plays, so that's it's right. Just got to be set.
We'll see how much picking or back picking they'll do on these plays. Well, Emily Modar takes a great screenshot.
That's a good screen.
It's really nice to see all those plays come together with the screen and the communication going out on the court.
I like that.
There we go.
TPC foul on number 4, Megan Smith. That's her second in the team's
The referees are keeping this clean. Number 13 wide open for that shot. That's a good look for her.
Megan Smith working hard, bring that
Up. Nice pass.
Nice clean passes.
Beautiful look. Screen action. Good luck.
Good job by Emily Montour. Number 8.
This was well set up by Steve's. On that as well with the screen.
That's right.
Team Ontario within 2.
I like BC split action. They have this X split action at the across the ball. Good luck. New 14-second shot clock.
He takes a shot.
Oh.
Uh,
Again, new shot clock.
New shot clock. Good job by Tara. Number two, Terry Ennis. Out there recovering the ball, so for good rebounds.
Team Ontario foul on number 13, Tamara Steves.
So on the pass.
Her first and the team's first foul.
Well, we haven't seen her. There's sidelight out of bounds now. Let's take a look at that. She's got the screen already set up. Oh, an easy recovery.
By Elise Rose.
Good defense, trying to keep Team Ontario outside the key. Forcing long shots. Great rebound by Danielle.
Danielle brings it right in. Number 13, Tamara Steves. Good shot. Good rebound. Another one for Team Ontario.
This is a close game. Good defense. Oh, great look inside. It's like that short corner ducking.
Number 10, Lynette Boland.
Yeah, that was a great cut by Steves.
Team Ontario is number 7, Keisha Penoff.
Great pass, Danielle, and one. That's a great pass from Steves.
Team BC foul on number 13, Elise Rose. That's her first and the team's fourth foul. Duplessis to complete the three-point play. Meanwhile, checking in for TBC is number 3, Ivy Boland.
Right, nice. Right look again. Oh. Great look in the short corner.
They're really taking advantage, Team BC, looking out for outlets.
Good passing.
Nice long pass.
Beautiful look.
Well played, number 7. Good shot by Keisha.
Good defense. They really look for that short corner.
Ontario is putting on the offensive pressure right now. Strong energy coming from corner Team BC.
Yeah. Nice look. I thought she was going to shoot that. I like that fake off. We're being more aggressive. Just trying to make sure that they can't get close to the paint. Great. They're looking for that screen action, the shot, outside shot. Same action with the inbounder getting the ball back. Looking for that top shot. Good pass. Steve is dangerous with the ball. And that's an end of one.
That's great. Set
beautiful 3-on-2 advantage. Good job.
TPC foul number 4, Megan Smith. That's her third personal foul.
Dangerous with the ball. You got to find her right away because she's already looking for that second pass. She's got vision all around her head. Good rebound, good speed. She's taken off. Oh, that slip to the rim was beautiful. But that's a great pass.
Ontario putting on the defense early.
Opening up the key.
A lot of back picking going on. Keisha Panoff's attempted a shot.
That was a good look. She was the open person. Again, just beautiful passing.
And timeout call by Team Ontario with 2:41 remaining before halftime.
They seem to know each other so well, Team BC, just in terms of like passing before she gets to the spot and really passing to the spot and know that she's going to get under it. It's beautiful.
They really do have a good synergy. A lot of experience playing together as well, Team BC.
Yes. Sometimes it's good to have that warm-up game. Because then, like, you got used to the gym, the rims. Oh, advantage again.
DBC gets it.
Great finish. 22-14 for DBC.
Oh, we're going for the... Got the rebound. Team BC was well set up for the box out for that second shot. Got to protect the rim. Oh, good luck.
Almost uncontested. Team Ontario just getting, I guess, a little synergizing their defense there.
Yes. Looking for that. They are really creating that wall around the perimeter.
They are very strong defense. I could see this pass play, number 3, Millie Houghton from Team Ontario, trying to create a screen for her teammate.
Oh, nice luck. Their slip action is very nice. Nice.
Good clean pass.
Good one. Oh, just a little too deep.
There you go.
Whoops.
Oh,
a little too strong.
Seconds left in the play.
Substitution for Team BC. Checking in is number 5, Lily Brooke.
Number 5, Lily Brooke for Team BC. On the court now. See Team BC trying to find those outlets and those holes in Team Ontario's defense. Team Ontario keeping it tight.
Yeah. Player to player.
Taking a lot of shots. That's it for the second quarter.
And that's happened, folks, with the TBC beginning.
Time to regroup.
14 lead at the break. As well.
scaffold a little. It's better. It's better. I see it. I can arrange myself not to see it. I will just make sure my the level is good.
And we're back at halftime. Wheelchair Basketball would like to thank its valued partners for their unwavering support. The Government of Canada, Ottawa Tourism, Hollister Limited, Armored Suits, Criminal Defense Lawyers, and Toyota Canada. You can follow Canada's national team as they seek to qualify for the Paris 2024 Summer Paralympic Games this summer. On April 17th to the 20th, the women's national team will have a chance to punch their ticket to Paris at the women's IWBF Repêchage Tournament in Osaka, Japan. You can find Wheelchair Basketball Canada on social media and on our website at wheelchairbasketball.ca. We're also thrilled to have some special guests in the crowd today and welcome students from the John McRae Secondary School as well as the Collège Catholique Saint-Virginaire. It's very interesting today, Fabienne, to see students from John McRae Secondary School doing commentating on the first game today.
Oh, wow. That's amazing. I think it's a great experience when you can get at the, you can get them to experience that and see if this is something they want to get involved in.
That's right. So especially getting involved with the National Sports Organization, seeing how everything is, the whole...
So we have some interesting stats here. So right now, Team BC is leading in assists. So they have 11 assists to the four assists from Team Ontario. They're getting good touches, they're just not finishing it. So I think their assist level would go higher. Rebounding, they're not bad. So 26 for Team Ontario to 23 of Team BC. So a lot of those other stats are close. Except, so offensive rebound 7 to 8, Team BC 7. 8 for Team Ontario. It's just that they're not finishing. They start finishing those, it's a closer game. Oh, we're right back at it.
Great energy by Team PC out there. Strong start by Team BC. Let's see if they can get the shot clock.
There you go. Emily had an opening that closed up pretty quickly. Got Bolin to Bolin, so there's a three Bolins on the team.
Three Bolins.
Looking for that next pass. There's 3 seconds left on the shot clock.
Let's go. Good shot. Hook shot. Unfortunately, not enough time to square the shot.
Team Ontario possession.
great pass to Danielle.
Danielle gets it right in.
That shot goes for Danielle Duplessis with a team-high 8 points.
Duplessis and Steve's, their connection right now is keeping them afloat.
Tara looking for an outlet. See if they can pierce Ontario's defense.
Oh, that inside look was amazing. Just again, throwing it to the spot. Just looking for that person running the middle of the paint.
Emily's looking for that outlet. Shot, let's see if Zoe gets it in. Good shot for Zoe.
The halftime was a good talk with coach because they came back with a different type of energy.
They have, they dialed it right in. Ontario playing a stronger defense this quarter. Really denying Team BC the ball. Really keeping him out of the paint this quarter.
Yeah, doing much better job of covering the short corner, keeping them outside of the paint, because that's where they were hurting them with the slips. No space to slip, it's perfect. This is becoming a very defensive game. Oh, they're going to try to keep Duplessis outside that key.
Emily Bondar takes a shot. Slight miss.
Yeah. Got the movement. Number six inside.
Another inbound for Team Ontario.
And number six for Boland is basically doing really well. She's 6 points, 4 offensive boards, 5 defensive boards. So she's really doing it at different parts of the game for them. Huge impact.
Looking for number 11, Zoe Hahn.
Good
out
pass.
There we go.
Oh, good luck.
It's a shot.
Yeah. Both teams are not making it easy for people to find anything in the paint, so kudos to both teams right now. Locked in on defense. Good luck.
A lot of shots by Team BC.
Team Ontario foul on 13. Tamara Steves picks up her second and the team's first foul.
Team BC subbing in number 13, Elise Froese.
Nice look. Oh, it's just a little too strong. Oh, good luck. Number two. Team BC with their brand of defense. Oh, we got her inside. She got position inside. Oh, didn't get the roll. That was great positioning in the paint.
Great passes all around. Team BC looking for that hole.
Beautiful look. nice look with the foul. You saw that one coming.
Yeah. Did give a chance for Emily Mondor to take the shot.
Team BC foul on number 6, Kim Boland, makes up her 2nd, and the team's first foul.
Yeah.
A pair of free throws for Amy Mondor.
That was great circling, being able to get behind the defense and finding that way. That's, I love their passing game. I need to borrow that for my academy.
A good shot, good sinker by Emily Madar.
Looking for someone in the paint. Does not. They're keeping them outside. Oh, she's a sharpshooter. They gotta know where she is.
Back-to-back buckets for Tara Yannis. Now with 8 points.
They're keeping Duplessis out. Oh, charge.
Team Ontario foul on number 3, Melanie Houghton. That's her first. Team's 2nd foul. And checking in for Ontario is number 10, Larissa McClellan.
Team Ontario getting in position for a strong defense, pairing up to their players.
That is setting up some screen action. Piling up on Team Ontario right now because they're trying to set up those screens. So closing that up.
Again, you mentioned at halftime they surely had a good discussion on how they're going to readjust their defense positioning and strategy.
Just a little bit of delay on the on starting the shot clock.
It's been excellent work today by all the volunteers. Good long weekend ahead. Lots of good.
Oh, look at that look. Oh, that was a great look. Shot clock.
Police froze.
Oh, they're looking for her again. Oh, there she is.
Yannis.
We gotta know where she is.
10 points.
She's got a beautiful, beautiful arc on that shot. Nice and smooth.
Be interesting to see now late this quarter, see if for defense they'll do a lot of player mismatches or matches, seeing taking advantage of mismatches, mm-hmm. and trying to force their way through the defense.
And checking in for Team Ontario is number 4, Charlotte
for Charlotte McElroy joining the team on the court for Team Ontario. Fresh energy on the court.
Oh, Duplessis was looking for that three-point shot. Good luck. Nice.
There we go. And we had a nice long shot. Tamara Steves does have that long shot. Team's definitely taking
good
advantage.
Good luck.
Oh. Good look inside. And a bucket by number 13, Elise Rose.
I think, like you were mentioning to me, the synergy with that team and knowing where they're going to be and the timing on their passes on time on target. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. Good luck. That's a great setup.
Great shot.
Going glass, Danielle Duplessis.
As she saw beyond the paint, saw her player out there.
I love the screens that they set, because by the time you try to adjust to that, it's too late. Oh, short corner again.
Melanie Houghton bringing up the ball. Yeah.
BC foul on number 4, Megan Smith. That's her 4th personal foul, and the team's in 2nd. And checking in for BC, number 7,
Megan Smith racking up those fouls in the third quarter. Good energy, much more aggressive quarter.
Oh, good rebound. Look at that passing action there. Oh, there we go. Oh. Beautiful.
Melody Hot and brings it in.
Yeah. They were expecting that the out of bounds person to get it.
That is number 3.
Her slipping down the middle, love it.
Team Ontario.
Undetected.
Out of looking for her. Oh, no one's on.
Nice long clean passes.
Oh, nice try. That was good defense. They saw that she was gonna slip in.
She took a good chance. She saw she was gonna beat the clock on that one.
Press!
Yeah. Oh, did you see that press action? I love that.
BBC calling for the press.
Yeah, 2 shots, get it!
That's the first time I saw that. That's pretty good.
Team Ontario foul on number 9, Danielle Duplessis, picks up her first. Yeah. Is the team's
Four fouls here, Ontario. They're keeping pretty consistent team to team at this point of the game. It's all good clean action. Very good sportsmanship both sides of the court.
Any chance to tell you that Toyota Canada is a proud mobility partner of Wheelchair Basketball Canada? Toyota's partnership with Wheelchair Basketball Canada represents their commitment to mobility and movement for all.
So for the press, the way when they set it up, like is the press more like taking some people away?
Yes.
Or okay, instead of guarding an area? Okay.
We'll
I'm see. Building my knowledge.
BC's actually calling for a press right now.
Yeah. Let's see. So that's getting them in trouble right now, not being able to find open people the full court.
So by pressing, they'll keep their defense off the on their they'll keep their defense on your offensive side. Hopefully catching those rebounds.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like, hey, where's my press break? That's what she's looking for. I need my press break. Who's coming back? And that's good because you're taking their best ball handler. There we go. Good screen. That's a good screen. Oh, beautiful. Oh,
Colin Kimmer got it in.
Wave the basket for Ontario foul on number 3, Melanie Haughton.
I love that little action. She gave you that little action at the when she caught the ball and curled in. That was beautiful. It's just a charge. That was the other point. Good job.
Good job on number 3, Melissa Haughton, for duking it out with her teammate.
Yeah.
Getting out there for defense. See if Team BC gets a shot clock. We're going to fight against it.
Oh, no rim. Oh, nice. They lost her.
Yeah. Molly Houghton squeaks in again. That's her hitting. That's it for the third quarter.
BC's still on top, 33-25. Following Canada's national teams as they seek to qualify for the Paris 2024 Summer Paralympic Games this summer. On April 17th, the women's national team will have a chance to punch their ticket to Paris at the women's IWBF Ripper Showers Tournament in Osaka, Japan. You can also watch the men's national team compete at the men's IWBF Ripper Showers Tournament.
All right, everybody's positioning.
Looking for an opening. Oh, this is not the player you want to leave open. Here we go.
There we go. Maybe Smith taking the shot.
Oh. They got the rebound. Oh.
That's number
those little box outs. This is our third Bolin. Oh, nice look. Ah, beautiful. Good job.
There it goes.
Wow.
Getting back picks.
Yes.
Melanie Hawthorne back picking for a teammate to get out of the gym, to get back on defense.
I love that.
Well played. It's awesome to see much more experienced players mentoring, helping out their teammates on the court as well.
Yeah, this is what I'm noticing. It's pretty good. Looking for that next pass. Go. Good job.
To Taylor. Oh, sorry, nice. Oh,
nice.
A shot.
Oh. Oh. Oh, looking for that next look. Ooh, and one.
Another foul of Team Ontario, number 14, Celine Gibb.
Substitutions coming in for BC, number 13, Elise Rose, and number 5, Lily Brooks.
We're starting to see the pace of the game pick up now.
To complete the 3-point play.
That those little box outs. Good job.
Excellent chair handling skills by Melanie Hoffman, number 3, Team Ontario.
Love the screen action that we saw for some of the players, the new players coming in, number 6. Nice pass. Very unselfish. I love that. This is their sweet spot. They love the short corner.
Number 13, Elise Froese from Team BC. Had a height advantage on that basket.
Yeah, they trying to keep them outside the paint.
Very tight defense, keeping it player to player. Ontario working hard to find that hole or that outlet. Another foul.
BC foul on number 4, Megan Smith. That is her 5th personal foul. And the team's first. And checking in for Smith is number 1, Katie Badger.
Let's see what they do.
Team BC slowing down the play, making sure they can.
Yeah, and then coach is telling them, I need to hear some talking. They're so quiet, so focused on what's supposed to be happening next.
That was a great screen play by number 5, number 3, Team BC.
Ooh, steal.
There we go.
That's a great steal.
Elise gets the steal.
And. Oh! That was a great look. Good steal. Good screen action there too. Now they need some movement. They need some movement. Good cat. Good one.
Good recovery on that side. Taking the shot to beat the shot clock. Unfortunately, she didn't have to square off for that one. Team BC working hard, keeping those some of the players out of play.
Slowing them down.
Transitioning to a 4-on-4 to a 5-on-5 play.
Got the blue ball.
Is number 8.
Sariana is coming off court. Number 2, BC. And number 8, Julia Townsend, getting in there.
Heidi, we need you at the top. Heidi, get at the top.
It's a good look. Good job.
6 minutes left in the quarter.
Good luck.
Good shot.
Yes, good passing. Good passing.
Nice attempt by number 5, Taylor Shaganessy. Taylor will have a shot. Two shots on fouls.
Melanie's doing a really good job of just facilitating the floor and passing. Looking like she passed off that little look that she had for a better, for a greater look. We said good to great all the time. Just a shot clock adjustment. Oh, we're quiet now. See the difference. That's what Team Ontario coach is talking about. I can't hear them on defense like we were hearing them before.
Yeah, energy level dissipating.
Yes.
Is that their strategy to bring on stronger in a few last few minutes?
Good passing. Finding her inside. That was nice.
Good shot. Good shot. Yeah.
Good job.
Shot goes for Celine Gibb.
Number 14, Celine Gibb. That's it in for Team Ontario.
Now let's see if we can hear Team Ontario and then being able to keep them outside the paint again.
They're keeping it tight.
Oh, so got the screen action on the other side.
Stop, please.
And with 4:31 remaining in the fourth, they were
looking.
Team Ontario.
Team Ontario calls out 8.
Special thanks to Lush Retail Limited and Good Life Fitness
Timeout.
For providing our pricing and our giveaways today.
For Dora Joe's joining us this late in the game, would like to invite them to follow Canada's national teams as they seek to qualify for the Paris 2024 Summer Paralympic Games this summer. From April 17th to the 20th, the women's national team will have a chance to punch their ticket to Paris at the women's IWBF Repêchage Tournament in Osaka, Japan. You can find Wheelchair Basketball Canada on social media and on our website at wheelchairbasketball.ca. I'd like to give out a big shout out to all the volunteers out here today providing the IWBF Wheelchair Basketball World Championship qualifiers.
Defense.
The volunteers have worked hard and they'll keep working hard over the weekend to promote and advance equitable, inclusive and high performance sports in Canada.
Beautiful pass. Find him in the short corner. About 4:10 left in this game. 11-point advantage for BC. Number 13's trying to slip in. I like the way they kept her outside the paint. 5 seconds left.
BC really taking advantage of that shot clock, making sure they can find that right outlet.
That's a good steal from Timo. Oh, nice look with the foul. I thought I saw one, but
nice pass.
My vintage point.
Pan off.
It's probably just like, hand is part of the ball.
All these throws, number 13 getting in there, setting herself up for that.
Time out, please.
Team BC calling up for timeout.
I'm wondering if that, was that a 3 seconds? Is that what they called? In the key, I missed that.
Xavier missed it.
Yeah.
Is that fun and inclusive sport? Is accessible right here in Ottawa.
They look like they're having a good time learning. Coach is high spirit.
Following the CWBL Women's National Championship.
I see a new faces up on Team Ontario this year.
And April 2nd.
I like that.
As they're mentoring their most recent additions to the team.
All equipment is provided, and the sessions are open to all skills and abilities.
I like that. As you grow the sport at every level, it's so important.
By scanning the QR code on any of the posters around this facility.
Especially on the women's side, it's really nice to see how much exposure now we're getting.
Yes.
So being able to get a lot more mentoring and grow the sport, wheelchair basketball, it's beautiful. Oops.
BC foul. Julian Dallison picks up her second, is the team's third foul. And substituting into the game for BC is number 6, Kim Boland.
Inbounding for Ontario, Tamara Steves.
Oh, nice look.
Pass going off for the basket. At number 7, Keisha Panoff trying to reach in there for the ball. But BC's defense is quite strong.
Possession.
14 seconds.
Good long shot.
Oh, nice luck.
Good long shot by Tamara Steves.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she's going to penetrate. Oh, they're closing that up pretty quickly. Oh, that was a great screen and roll. Set that screen.
Going glass.
Forced Team Ontario to peel onto the ball.
Tamara taking time, making sure we can look out for those outlets. Yeah, good communication on the court. And Charlotte McElroy for Tamara takes a shot. Successful. Now BC coming in.
Love to see the smiles on their faces when they're playing. It's great. Oh, look at that. Oh, that was a great look.
Good shot by number 13, Elise Froese. Another one for Team BC.
Nice luck.
Oh, nice.
Oh, that was beautiful. Such a good ball handler.
Oh, nice.
Pressure, good luck. Oh.
There we go.
Rose, back to back buckets. 10 points.
Another basket, number 13. All these froze.
1 minute remaining.
Oh.
Ontario just called out for a timeout. So they'll get it before the clock runs out. BC will take their time going in.
Charge.
BC foul.
We had BC call out the timeout.
Yeah, Team Ontario's defense is that they're good doing person to person. As soon as now there's a help defense, we're not rotating. So they're opening up right under the rim. But you could tell that he's got some new players in there and getting used to what the rotation is. It's always those growing pains, but it's great experience for them. I'm sure the next game will be a little different because now that you got your first game in, take a look at what we need to improve on.
But Team Ontario's biggest challenge is always the distance travel to always train as a team with
That's true.
Throughout the province. A lot of weekends to commit.
That's a good point. Good luck.
Shot by Charlotte. And she sinks it in. Number 4, Charlotte McElroy.
Charlotte McElroy lets it fly.
She was open. She took that opportunity.
Ten seconds.
Gotta admit, I really like Charlotte's pink wheelchair.
I do.
Color.
I love it. No.
Excellent last quarter for both teams.
47, Team Ontario 30.
Final score, 47. Team BC, 30. Team Ontario.
For Team Ontario, Danielle Duplessis led her team with 10 points. And for Team BC, Lynette Bowman led 3 players in double figures with a team high 11 points. 10 points for Elise Froese. And 10 points for Tara Youngs.
in case you didn't get that online for Team Ontario. We had 10 points for Danielle Duplessis. And on Team BC, top scorers were Lynette Bowen, number 10, with 11 points. And number 13, Elise Froese, with 10 points, along with number 2, Tara Yanis, with another 10 points.
Wow. Well balanced.
Great play by both teams on each side.
It's a well-balanced game, too. So we had a well-balanced game of both teams doing really well on the boards. So 48-49, so 48 for Team Ontario. The one differentiator is 20 assists to 11 assists. Mm. And that's just us Team Ontario finishing. But, well, like, I think it was a great learning experience for the Team Ontario with the mentoring that you can see is happening there. And you mentioned it at the quarter, the synergy on the BC team created those 9-plus assists that they got, compared to Team Ontario.
Great energy throughout both teams throughout the game. Very DFC. Quite surprised Team BC kept it really high energy for second game today.
And I learned a lot from you during this game, so thank you for helping me out on that. But it's so much fun to watch basketball in the different vintage point.
It's always great to give back to the sport every way we can. So thank you everyone for joining us for Ontario and BC.
And thank you.
And thank you very much, Fabienne, for joining us today. It's a wonderful game.
Oh, love the game. Thank you so much, Bernie, for helping me out.
L'équipe Québec affrontera l'équipe Mix. Ne ratez pas l'action.